Hi students, my name is Seema and today we are going to see standard 12th ka lesson. The name of the lesson is respiration and circulation. So before moving to our topic, let's see what we have studied in the standard 10th. So standard 10th mein we have studied life processes. So hum log ne dekha tha life processes kya hai. So which are the life processes we have seen? Yes, we have seen nutrition, excretion, circulation, reproduction. Okay, so there are various life processes we have seen in the standard 10th. So one of the life processes here we are going to study, that is respiration. Okay, so whatever food we are eating, that food is converted into chemical energy. Means to do all these life processes, we require energy. So from where we are getting this energy? This energy we are getting through the process called as respiration. तो हम लोग ये जो अपनी भी जितनी भी लाइफ प्रोसेसेस हैं उनको करने के लिए हम लोग को एनर्जी की जरूरत पड़ती है और ये एनर्जी जो प्रोसेस से हमको मिलती है दैट प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज रेस्पिरेशन. ओके, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड? नाउ वी विल सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन. सो व्हाट इज रेस्पिरेशन? रेस्पिरेशन इज अ बायोकेमिकल प्रोसेस. व्हाट इट इज? इट इज अ बायोकेमिकल प्रोसेस वेयर organic food or organic compound is converted into chemical energy. Okay, which chemical energy? That is ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate. Okay, let's see the formula or the equation. So here respiration, here C6H12O6 means glucose. This glucose is oxidized. Oxidized means it combines with oxygen to form carbon dioxide, water molecule and 38 ATP molecules. 38 ATP molecules means what? It is a energy. So your organic compound is oxidized to convert it into chemical energy or to liberate or to generate chemical energy in the form of ATP. Understood? So again we'll see the definition of respiration. What is respiration? Respiration is a biochemical process where organic compounds are oxidized to form a chemical energy or to liberate chemical energy in the form of ATP. Okay, have you understood? So we have seen the definition of respiration. Now respiration हो रहा है लेकिन respiration के लिए कोई place चाहिए, कोई जगह चाहिए. So the place where the respiration occurs, okay, the site of gaseous exchange. Respiration is what? It is nothing but the gaseous exchange. Okay, so the place where the gaseous exchange takes place is called as respiratory surface. Okay, so the place where the gaseous exchange takes place is called as respiratory surface. Next, which we are going to see part, that is features needed for respiratory surface. So ये respiratory surface है, वहां से respiration होना है या gaseous exchange होना है, लेकिन वो surface कैसा चाहिए? For example, we'll take the example of the cricket match. अगर match करना है तो match के लिए जो ground रहेगा वो ground कैसा होना चाहिए? Football का match है तो उसका ground कैसा होना चाहिए? ऐसे उनके उनके लिए एक requirement होती है कि ये ground football का ground ऐसा होना चाहिए, cricket का ground ऐसा होना चाहिए. तो similarly, if the gaseous exchange is taking place, gaseous exchange हो रहा है तो वो surface कैसा चाहिए? Okay, the first one, it should have large surface area. As gases are going to exchange, it should have large surface area. Second thing, the surface should be thin. Gas exchange होना है तो surface thin चाहिए. अगर thick रहेगा तो it will be very difficult for the gaseous exchange. Okay, the first one is it should have large surface area. Second one, the surface should be thin, highly vascular and permeable to allow gaseous exchange. Highly permeable. Okay, have you understood? Next one, the surface should be moist. Have you understood? Now we are going to see the gaseous exchange. As we know that the living world is divided into two kingdoms, that is plants and the animals. Okay, so plants or animals mein pura world divided hai. To agar gaseous exchange ho raha hai to har ek ki requirement different hai. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर क्रिकेट का मैच हो रहा है तो क्रिकेट के मैच के लिए जो ग्राउंड रहेगा वो ग्राउंड जैसा रहना चाहिए उसकी रिक्वायरमेंट डिफरेंट रहेगी एज कम्पेयर टू द फुटबॉल मैच. ओके, अगर वो फुटबॉल के लिए ग्राउंड यूज हो रहा है तो उसकी रिक्वायरमेंट ग्राउंड की रिक्वायरमेंट अलग रहेगी. तो सिमिलरली इफ द गैशियस एक्सचेंज टेक्स प्लेस इन द प्लांट्स the different organs are different as well as the method or the procedure is different as compared to the animals. Okay, so now we'll see the plants. In plants gaseous exchange takes place through diffusion. Okay, how the gaseous exchange takes place? It takes place through diffusion. So in here we are going to see the flowering plants, terrestrial flowering plants and the woody flowering plants. Okay, so in terrestrial flowering plants they are having minute openings or pores on stems, leaves and roots. Okay, they are having air spaces. Okay, through which the exchange of gases takes in place. Okay. So terrestrial flowering plants have air spaces between cells of stem, leaf and root through which the diffusion of gas takes place. So here oxygen is diffuses into air spaces through stomata. Okay, and carbon dioxide and water is diffuses out with the help of stomata. So here I have drawn the diagram, leaf caper, small spore, openings, that openings are nothing but the stomata. Okay, now next we are moving towards the woody flowering plants. So here I have shown one bark. This bark is having small dots, means patches. These patches are nothing but the openings through which exchange of gases takes place, and these openings are called as lenticels. Okay, now they have external impervious bark, that is where the exchange of gases takes place through lenticels. So what are lenticels? Just now I told you that is small pores on the barks. Have you understood? So this is about the plants. Now we are moving towards the animals. Okay, so in short, the animals having different organs or surfaces through which exchange of gases takes place. Okay, so here we have taken few examples. So through plasma membrane, exchange of gases takes place in the sponges and the cnidarians. Then through moist skin, frog does the exchange of gases. Booklungs, with the help of booklungs, spider does. Then book gills, limulus. Spiracles, that is insects. External gills, that is salamanders. Internal gills, fishes. And lungs, that is reptiles, mammals, birds, all are done their exchange of gases with the help of lungs. So this is a very in short I have given the examples. Hope you have understood this much. So in the next video we are going to see the next part of the lesson. So by that time, if you like my video, please like it, share it, subscribe it and press the bell icon for the further notification. Thank you.